Hi, I'm Dr. Mike Jankowski-Lorek, and I'm Director of Consulting and Cybersecurity Expert at CQURE. This time, I would like to show you how UAC and its bypass methods really work. This topic is also discussed really in depth on our blog at CQUREacademy.com by my colleague Adrian Denkiewicz. First, let me briefly explain what UAC is. The UAC stands for User Account Control, which is available in Windows operating systems since Windows Vista. I bet that at some point in time, you have already seen the UAC prompt. When everything is graying out or disappearing, and the only pop-up message is visible with the question, do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? This technology was introduced in Windows to countermeasure bad user behavior, which utilize highly privileged users with account administrator rights to perform daily tasks like receiving mails or browsing internet. Without UAC, any action performed using an administrative account could have destructive results like encrypting the whole disk content or stealing your own private data. When UAC is enabled, even an administrative account does not have a danger privileges. They have to be explicitly requested. Requesting them typically just require clicking on a yes button, but it cannot be done through a script or using a remote session, as the message is displayed on a secure desktop. Let me show you one of the examples of bypassing the UAC. First, let's open a new command prompt window and list user group membership. The command is whoami/groups. Okay, so this is an administrator. And we do not have privileges other than the standard one. So next, let's open the authorization manager, asman.msc, and let's look for the process that is newly created by, for example, using the proc mod. Let's first open the CMD and look for the permissions that currently this user has. First, the group membership. This is the built-in administrator. And as you can see, whoami/priv is giving us that this is the basic privileges that we have in our system. Then asman.msc, this is MMC console. And in the process explorer, you can see that it's running as a high mandatory label. So let's open the help. And in the help, we can look for the view source. Now this is this notepad that has the same access token. So let's open just the cmd.exe from it. And now the cmd.exe will have as well the high mandatory label, which is granting us additional privileges, as you can see here. This method of bypassing UAC is just one of many available in the system. It is not a good method if we want to do it from the remote session. For this kind of bypassing, you can use one of the advanced techniques like DLL hijacking, registry manipulation, user interface privilege isolation, COM interfaces, or always notify. All of these techniques you will find described in detail on our blog at CQUREacademy.com. To sum it up, UAC is quite useful when it comes to preventing accidental system destruction. At the same time, it doesn't prevent from getting administrative rights back and should be considered as a security boundary at all. There are numerous methods that pen tester can use to bypass UAC without having access to the graphical user interface. So it's much better to properly plan which accounts for what privileges should be used to run services and applications. Remember, if you want to stay up to date with CQURE Academy news, sign up for the newsletter and follow our website, CQUREacademy.com.